We've got all sorts of waste reduction initiatives at Melbourne farmers markets. We firstly banned the plastic shopping bag in 2007, and since then we've introduced a wash-up station to tackle the single-use plastics in the food and events industry. We wash up about 500 cups a day. The punters return their cups after they've enjoyed them around the market, and then we have a commercial dishwasher that our staff or volunteers assist us with washing up, and of course they go back into the system over and over.
It just makes sense to be able to provide a glass option that people can, you know, have their juices in and then just return to the wash station, and for those glasses to remain in circulation as opposed to using a single-use disposable that ends up in landfill. There's a cost benefit as well, so with the glasses you invest a little bit more up front, but then over time it becomes more sustainable as well for the business.
The initiative tackles a bit of everything, I think, and as a community that's really what we've got to do. It's the little steps that are going to add up to create the bigger change. So I think that goes across all the initiatives that we're trying to see coming into law, but also just into practice, good practice, without it being imposed on us.
This particular project is really about the community. It's about starting conversations about trying to use what we have and look after what we have. And while we do divert, you know, quite a lot of plastic from being recycled or even going to landfill, really it's about the conversations.
Personally, I think it's great to be conscious of one's environmental footprint. So, and as a business owner, it's also important to consider how the operation can be better for the environment and the planet. And so that's one of the main drivers behind going to reusables as well.